everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Temi, a software engineer working in the UK. I recently got my first job as a software engineer. So in this video, I thought it would be good to talk about my interview experience. I'll be focusing on behavioural interviews for junior software engineers in the UK. As usual, any resources that I mentioned throughout this video will be in the description box below. And before I jump into the video, don't forget to like and subscribe to see more content from me. So the first stage is usually a call with someone from HR or recruitment just to check through your CV. So this phone call will be an informal chat about your experience, your CV, and they might even talk to you a little bit about the company as well. At this stage, you might be asked about your salary expectations for the role, and my advice is to hold off from giving them a number early on if you can do so, just because you don't want to lowball yourself early on. Most companies will have a salary range they can pay you, so it's a good idea to find out more about the responsibilities of the role and also find out a little bit more about the average salary for that role in your area before having a discussion about your salary expectations. Once you've got to a later stage of the interview and you've done your research, then it's probably a good idea to have a serious conversation about salary expectations. If your phone call with the recruiter or the person in HR goes well, you'll then be moved on to the one-to-one interview, also known as the behavioral interview. This stage of the interview is about the interviewers getting to know your personality and understanding your experience a bit better. You could be being interviewed by engineers from the company you want to work at, or if it's a small company, you might be interviewed by the founder. Most of the time, you'll be told who's going to interview you. So if you are, it's a good idea to do some research beforehand. Before each of my interviews, I actually had a look at my interviewers' LinkedIn profiles on private mode, and I just paid attention to any experience that they might have and their field of expertise as well, just to get to know them a little bit better. From doing your background research, you might be able to get a feel for what kind of questions you might be asked based on your interviewer's field of expertise. If you're being interviewed by non-technical people, then it's unlikely that you'll get any technical questions, if any. If you're being interviewed by any engineers, then be prepared to answer any technical questions that might be related to your role. Before you jump into the interview, it's a good idea to ask the interviewer about themselves and how their day was, just to break the ice a little bit and to seem a little bit more personable. I'm about to go over some potential questions that you might be asked. And for these questions, I'll normally plan my answers beforehand and go through them several times with a friend or a family member. That way, when I'm doing the real interview, my answers are a lot more likely to flow fairly smoothly and be quite coherent. So the first question you're guaranteed to get is, tell me about yourself. And the best way to answer this question is to briefly talk about how you got to where you are now. So you can talk about your current role at work and how long you've been there, or if you're a university or college student, then you can talk about the course you're doing and maybe any modules that you're enjoying. Then you can talk about your educational background and any relevant experience that you might have. Briefly talk about what you did after university and any experience that you might have obtained. Then go into more detail about what you do at work, and you can also talk about any related hobbies that you might have. You can also briefly talk about anything that you might be passionate about within software engineering, such as web accessibility or the cloud. You can then finish off by talking about anything that you wish to achieve in the future. Another guaranteed question is, why have you applied for this role? And you might get a follow-up question asking why you want to work at that company. Make sure you do extensive research using the company's website, so whatever answer you give is aligned with the industry that the company is in. Then talk about what you're particularly interested in. When researching about the company and its field, it's worth taking a note of any issues that the industry or the company is currently facing, such as upgrading any legacy systems or making certain web pages more accessible for its users. keep a note of any technology that the company currently uses and try to find out more about it. A lot of companies might have blogs on their website where they talk about any projects they're working on, issues they're facing, or any tools that they're using. So really look on their website, have a dig around, and read as much as you can. Anything you've written on your CV is fair game. So if you've talked about any personal projects on there, make sure you know them pretty well. You can also expect to be asked about any technologies that you've listed on your CV. So for example, you might be asked about the limitations of any tech that you've worked with. So that's something that you might want to look up and research beforehand. My advice is to avoid putting anything on your CV that you're unsure about or can't answer, because not being able to answer questions about yourself or your experience doesn't look great. You may be asked about your strengths and your weaknesses too. If you're asked about your weaknesses, make sure you give a real answer, but try not to mention anything that might put you at a disadvantage, such as not being able to complete work on time. Instead, you could phrase it as, "Sometimes I struggle with managing a heavy workload, but I'm working on that by trying to prioritize tasks in order of importance." So whatever it is that you say, just make sure you counteract that by saying what it is you're trying to do in order to improve on your weakness. For your strengths, if you give examples and you're specific about what your strengths are, then you'll avoid coming off as arrogant. So instead of saying you took the lead on a project because no one else was capable, you can instead say that you decided to step up and be team lead because you're good at organizing, delegating tasks, and timekeeping. You'll most certainly be asked, "Tell me about a time when you had to solve a complex task under pressure." For this type of question, I highly recommend that you plan your answers beforehand so that when you're giving your answer in the interview, you're talking in a way that's coherent and that is easy to follow. For these kind of questions, I normally approach them by using the STAR technique. So this is when you answer your question by talking about the situation, the task, the action taken, and then the result of your task. For the situation, you should talk about the issue that you are facing. And for the task, you should talk about what the complex task was that you had to do. Try to avoid going into too much detail at this stage because the interviewer is unlikely to understand anyway, so the context is quite irrelevant to them. Then you should go into more detail about the action taken because this is the most important part. So talk about how you overcame the complex task and go into detail about what you did to solve it. And lastly, you should discuss the outcome or the result of your task. If you're leaving your current company, you might be asked why you're leaving. In fact, I got asked this question at every single interview I did, but I was never caught off guard because I prepared my answers beforehand. For this question, be honest without being disrespectful or rude. If you were treated badly at your previous company, then obviously talk about it, but just do so in a way that's respectful, so don't point fingers or try and put the blame on anyone, as it may rub the interviewer the wrong way, making them slightly reluctant to hire anyone who speaks negatively of their previous workplace. Thank you all so much for watching. I really hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed watching this video, and feel free to leave any video suggestions in the comment section below. Bye, see you in my next video.